You remind me of me, but without the bounty on your hands.
Okay guys, it's finally time to talk about Galaxy's Edge. I've been looking forward to making this video for like weeks, like since I got my reservation. I've been so excited about it. But after the event actually happened, I found myself procrastinating a little bit. And I think part of it is because I just needed to decompress and figure out what I wanted to include and, you know, etc. But it also occurred to me that no video I could possibly make, no video anyone could possibly make, is going to be as cool as seeing Galaxy's Edge in person. So that's kind of a lot of pressure. But once I admitted it to myself, it took some of the pressure off. So I'm just gonna talk about how my friends and I spent our time at Galaxy's Edge. Hopefully it will be helpful to you as you plan your trip. You can also please ask any questions that you have, and also tell me how your trip went, if you've been there already, or if you plan to go, what are some things that you're excited about? Okay, so if you know me or you know me through social media, you know that I actually spend a lot of time at Disneyland by myself, and that was my original plan for Galaxy's Edge. I just made my reservation just for me, one person, single rider, and I was fine with that. But a couple of days before my reservation, Disneyland contacted me and asked if I wanted to add up to 5 people to my flight crew, and I said, yeah, so... I asked a few people. I ended up finding 4 friends who wanted to come with me, which I think added to the experience a lot. Having the opportunity to pilot the Millennium Falcon with a group of your friends is cool as hell. So one of my friends who went with us was Lisa. You might know her as Happiest Vegan on Earth. She does all of the vegan Disney food guides that I reference so often. Pretty much every time I go to the park, I have her website pulled up on my phone. So it was cool to like have the actual person there. This is the first time we had met, and the first time we'd gone to the parks together. So she had actually been to Galaxy's Edge before, and as soon as we got into the land, she very generously volunteered to stand in line for Oga's Cantina for us. Currently the reservation system is like a virtual queue. They're not calling it a reservation, but that's basically, I think, what it is. You get in line and then they tell you what time to come back. And so since Lisa had been there before, she said she would be the one to wait in line, put all of our names in, and then we could kind of go explore a little bit. And that worked out perfectly because we kind of got to see some of the stuff that she had done already. We kind of wandered around basically with our jaws dropped, eyes wide open, just mesmerized by everything. We also went to the Millennium Falcon and got our pictures taken. By the time we were done with that, we were hungry. Lisa had made it through the line for the cantina, made a reservation. So we headed over to Docking Bay 7 to get some food. It was super hot that day, and also just being really excited, I wasn't ready for like a heavy meal yet, but they have something on the kids menu that is called, what is it called? Garden something. It's basically lettuce, veggies, breadsticks, hummus, and edible dirt, edible soil, whatever, same thing. So it's like made out of nuts. It kind of reminded me of like walnut-based taco meat, if you've ever had that, but it's not taco flavored. And it was good, I liked it. We also at that point put our mobile order in for blue milk, which I recommend doing. As soon as we got into Galaxy's Edge, the line for blue milk was like crazy long. So I think it's a good idea to do that, put your mobile order in while you're off doing something else, and you can choose the time that you want to go pick it up, and there you literally just walk up to the counter and grab it. So that worked out really well. Also, what are the odds Matt and I would show up wearing the exact same sunglasses? Don't answer that. Never tell me the odds. So then it was time to ride the Millennium Falcon Smuggler's Run. The line was not bad when we were there. I think it was 20-25 minutes. But it went by so fast because the queue is so interesting. I actually didn't take any pictures or video while I was in there. I kind of wish I did. There were a lot of things about Galaxy's Edge where I really was torn between wanting to pull out my camera or my phone and take photos and videos, and also just wanting to be in the moment and just absorb it for myself. So I did a lot of that. I did a lot of just looking around. And next time I go, I definitely will take more photos and videos, but this time, I kind of just wanted to experience it. So the end of the queue is actually, you're kind of in the Millennium Falcon. That's cool enough by itself. Like, honestly, there's a lot of things that I didn't notice just because I was so in awe.
So for example, little cutout beds that are in the wall of the Millennium Falcon, like where you see Chewbacca after he's got hit by a blaster and the medic is treating him and tells him like what a brave guy he is. Those are in there, and also the control panel that Leia's working on when Han shows up and like she calls him a scoundrel. That is also in there, and I totally didn't see any of that stuff, and I don't know if it's because they took us a different way or because I just wasn't paying attention. I have a feeling it's because they took us a different way, but that's definitely something I want to watch for next time. Also, yes, this is a different day. I totally screwed up the original clip and had to record it over, but I didn't want to cut it out. So, okay, back to the original.
So when you get to the end of your queue and it's time to board the Falcon, they'll assign you one of three roles, technically four roles. Left pilot, right pilot, engineer, or gunner. So on our first flight, I got left pilot. I was also dressed as Han Solo, and if you had told me at any point in my life that I would be dressed as Han Solo flying the Millennium Falcon, I would definitely have not believed you. Like, this was an unbelievable experience. So you don't really get to choose what role you do. They just kind of hand you a card and that's what you are. But you can obviously trade with the people in your party if they want to trade.
You will be intercepting a first order trading shipment of coaxium. Gunners, you clear the path. Pilots, line up behind the train. And engineers, you harpoon that precious cargo. Now, as you go forth, my friends, I want to remind you to be careful. Safety first. Well, profit first, but safety's a close second. I want to make sure you and the cargo get back with no mishaps.
So, flying the Falcon was a lot harder than I would have thought. I can't say that anything I've done in my life has prepared me, trained me to be a pilot. Basically, if you remember the scene of Rey and Finn taking off the Millennium Falcon in The Force Awakens, that is what it was like. Lots of collisions, very messy, very awkward, don't know what we're doing. But it was so fun. It was so fun. We flew it again later, and I can't say that we got any better. But, you know, we'll practice.
Who is right? If we lead them back, they might find the resistance. You did it!
So our reservation time was from 5 to 9 p.m. and as we were leaving the Falcon, it was already about 7:30, which was the time they told us to come back to Oga's Cantina. So we basically left the Falcon, headed back over there. They told us that our reservation wasn't ready yet, but they also let us in anyway. And we got a standing table right next to DJ Rex. So if you're not familiar with Rex, he was actually the original pilot from Star Tours before it was C-3PO and R2-D2. And I kind of missed him. So it was cool to see him again. Now he's a DJ and he's still kind of a screw up, but it's endearing. He's a lovable screw up.
That one's for all you fine travelers out there. Never stop exploring, or smuggling, or hunting for bounty, or whatever it is you do out there. No one in the galaxy boogies like us!
So the cantina was really cool. I feel like I'm using that word a lot. Cool, awesome, amazing, whatever. It's true. One thing I'm kind of sad we missed, so DJ Rex has a large catalog of tunes that he's playing, and I was kind of bummed that I wasn't expecting to hear the original Cantina Band song from A New Hope, and that's what ended up happening. I didn't hear it, but later on social media, I saw that there is a remix version that he's playing. So I don't know how many songs he has, but I mean, we were there for probably 20 or 30 minutes, probably 30 minutes at least, and didn't hear it. So, but hopefully that's something that happens when we're there in the future. So by the time we got out of the cantina, I think it was about 8:40, and we were deciding, we knew we wanted to ride the Millennium Falcon again, but we were trying to decide if there's anything else we wanted to do last minute. And we literally decided the best use of our time was to just split up, go through anything we wanted to do as quickly as possible, and then meet back at the Millennium Falcon like a couple minutes before 9. So that plan worked out pretty well. The cast member told us you can get in line for the Falcon basically right up until the end of your reservation period. So if you're trying to get the most of your time out of your reservation window, that might be a good way to go. So on our second ride, I got left pilot again. And as much as I really wanted to fly the Falcon again, I also thought it would be cool to kind of switch and see things from another perspective and also give one of my friends a chance to pilot. So this time it was Gunner, which was a little bit less cool, but still pretty cool. So I didn't notice this the first time we rode, but I had heard that depending on how you fly, the exit looks different. If you fly really well, and you, as you're walking out, everything in the Falcon looks normal. And if you fly really poorly, as you're walking out, everything is kind of beat up and crappy looking. So this time while we were walking out, I noticed some of the lights were flickering a little bit. I think on our second ride, we actually flew a little bit worse than the first one. I could be wrong on that. So anyway, if you have flown the Falcon and you know what I'm talking about, if you happen to notice as you were leaving what the exit looked like and if that seemed to correlate with your performance at all, let me know, because I'm really curious about this. So as we're leaving the Falcon and coming back into the land, it took me a minute to process what we were hearing, but I was hearing some loud bangs and I thought maybe that's part of the ride, maybe that's part of the damage that we did, I don't know. And then as we got out, I realized it was the fireworks. So perfect timing, really amazing. We got to watch the Disneyland fireworks go off over the Millennium Falcon at Black Spire Outpost. So after the fireworks, it was well past our reservation time. It was probably 9:40, 9:45. And what I had heard about the reservation window is that if you overstay your welcome, stormtroopers will escort you out. I didn't see any of that happening. And I was also really hungry, so I decided to push my luck, okay? Don't tell anybody. So we went to Docking B7 again, and this time I got to try the Aetherian Garden Loaf, which is the thing that I wanted to try the most in Galaxy's Edge. It's an Impossible-based meatloaf with mashed potatoes and veggies and mushroom gravy, and it was really, really, really good. So I didn't actually take a picture of the one that I ate, but I'm going to go ahead and plug this again. Go to Happiest Vegan on Earth. That is Lisa's website, and she has photos, videos, everything you could possibly want to know about Galaxy's Edge vegan food and vegan food in Disneyland in general. If you're vegan and you plan on going to the parks, definitely something you want to check out. So by this point, our other friends had left. It was just Lisa and I. She got the popcorn from Katsaka's Kettle, which I got to try also. It was really interesting. It's a combo of blue and red popcorn kernels. The blue is blueberry lemon pound cake flavor, and the red is chili lime flavor. And it kind of tasted like Fruit Loops a little bit, but in popcorn form. And I liked it. I don't know if it's something that I would have every time that I go, but it's definitely a good snack to kind of get you around the park and a flavor combination that you might not get elsewhere. So Lisa and I were talking, and you know, even though at this point it was probably about almost 11, so a little bit past our 9 o'clock reservation end, I mentioned that I thought the 4-hour window was a good amount of time to kind of do everything, do the things that you really, really want to do, and kind of get a quick look at everything else and think about what you want to do on your next trip. But I kind of mentioned, like, you know, I got to do everything that I wanted to do that day, and I was really happy with how we spent our time. And at that moment, we were like just finishing our food, and then Chewbacca shows up. So Chewbacca goes walking by, and I realized that was the one thing that I wanted to do that I didn't do. I mean, come on, I was dressed like Han Solo. Of course I have to take a picture and say hi to Chewbacca. So he goes walking by. So Docking Bay 7 is kind of like above the Millennium Falcon. There's like a little platform where you can walk out and just like look at it. That's a good place to take pictures. So he walks past where we are and walks onto that platform. He says hi to a couple people, and then he's like looking at the Falcon. And then he walks down off the platform toward the Falcon, toward the people, toward the cast members who are running the attraction. And he's kind of throwing a fit. So he's got his arms in the air. He's yelling. He's upset. He's angry with Hondo Ohnaka for letting people fly the Falcon and crash it all day. And at that point, him and his handler are kind of going around and interrogating people. Like, did you fly the Falcon today? How many times did you crash? Did you do a good job? Like, what was your role? So that was really fun, and I ended up getting to take a picture and give him a hug. So that was a great way to end our night, and we decided it was time to leave Batuu. Pretty much as soon as I walked out the exit, though, I missed it, and I wanted to go back, but soon enough, we will be there again. God, you know. Okay, so I asked for questions on social media, and I got a few, so I'm gonna go ahead and answer those now. One of the most frequently asked questions was, is blue milk good? And I am glad I tried it, because I mean, obviously I wanted to try it because of the experience, but I didn't really expect it to be good, and it's like $8. So, and also I knew we were gonna go to Oga's Cantina, so I was like, I don't really wanna get two different beverages. But I'm really glad I tried it. I did think it was good. No one in our group ordered the green milk. From what I've heard, the green milk is not quite as enjoyable. I definitely will want to try it at some point. But the green milk is like more of a citrus flavor. They're both vegan, and they're both coconut milk and rice milk based. But yeah, the green milk is more of a citrusy flavor, and then the blue milk is a combination of tropical flavors, and I couldn't really put my finger on what flavor it was. I could kind of taste the coconut, but other than that, it was just kind of like a creamy, delicious, like ice creamy treat. And I kind of think they did it on purpose. Like, a lot of the Galaxy's Edge food is like, it's kind of familiar, but you can't quite put your finger on like why. So the blue milk is dragon fruit, pineapple, crap, what is it? Let me look at the list. It is pineapple, lime, watermelon, and dragon fruit. My friend read that list while we were drinking it, and I could taste the dragon fruit after he said it, but before that, I had no idea what it was. But yeah, it was really good. I definitely think it's worth a try. Can you tell I'm at work right now? So to answer your question, yes, I think it was good. Another question I got was, are there droids rolling around Batuu? And so not yet. I had heard that rumor. I think it's not a rumor. I think it's official that there were meant to be droids kind of just cruising around. So I don't think that's happening yet. I think that the official word is that they're trying to make sure everything's going smoothly first. I heard that they're waiting for the crowds to die down, which during the reservation period, the crowds aren't bad. I think the crowds are gonna amp up after the reservation period, and I have a feeling they're gonna be that way for a while. So I don't know when we'll be seeing droids, but I am definitely looking forward to that. But there were a lot of people who built their own droids at the droid depot. And because it was so not crowded, people were just able to take their droids out and play with them, like out in the land. So there were droids around, they just weren't the droids you're looking for. Oh God. And last question, and this is a question that I have too. I don't know exactly what the answer is, but people are asking what the procedure is going to be to get into Galaxy's Edge after the reservation period is up. So Galaxy's Edge technically is open to the public on June 24th, which is coming up really soon. I don't think we have an official plan what entrance is going to be like at that point. I've heard that they're doing a virtual queue, and it sounds like it might work kind of like a fast pass, where you go, you put your name in, they tell you what time to come back. And I'm not sure if it's gonna be a 4-hour window or not. I expect that, you know, as this date is coming up pretty soon, we're gonna hear more from Disney within the next few days, I would think. And I'm definitely looking forward to that information, because typically I don't go to Disneyland all like to spend a whole day there. I just go for a few hours at a time. And things that require a reservation like that, or like I never get a fast pass for Fantasmic, because you have to go first thing in the morning. And then they sell out for the rest of the day. So it's gonna be hard for me if I have to like say show up first thing in the morning to get a boarding pass for Galaxy's Edge, and then my entrance time is like at 5 p.m. That's probably not something I'm gonna be able to do. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to hearing those details, and hopefully it's something that I can work with my schedule and for everyone's schedule who wants to go. Because I know it's gonna be a bummer too, even if you plan the whole day, if you're planning on vacation or you're planning to just take the day off work and you go to Galaxy's Edge in the morning and then you can't get in. But I don't know. I mean, the reservation period has gone really well so far. Like, the crowds have been really manageable. Hopefully Disney knows what they're doing. I think they do. They're kind of experts at this stuff. But yeah, I am really looking forward to going to Galaxy's Edge again. And next time I go, I promise I'll take more photos, more videos. Please ask any questions if you have them, or if there are specific things that you want to see more of that you want me to cover next time. And I definitely will do that. So I think that's it for this vlog. Till the spire. That means bye in Batuu. All right, see you later.